Anyway, so I think, let's test the roof. Actually, we didn't really look at the roof. It's a boat, right? I guess. I think we could add like a bit more contrast to the AC units. They look kind of flat. Let's see. Disable these adjustments for now. Where's the AC? So what does the AC contain? All that stuff. So I'll add the curves adjustment layer. Just clip it to the AC. So I'm using only on that. And I'll find this brightness. So it's about there. Again, I'll drag this out. So I'll add like 2 points. I don't want to affect the darks too much. I want to increase the contrast between the midtones here. You know, like this. This is crazy, but I'll adjust it. Yes. So I can go really crazy. So it's obvious to see what I'm doing. And then I can just reduce the opacity of the layer itself. And the good thing about this, if this was all made in 8-bit, it would look worse. Because there's more values that it can extract like by increasing the contrast here. So anyway, this is how it looks. I'll actually make it a bit darker as well, like this. And I'll reduce the opacity, let's see, 40%. Maybe that's 30% for now. I forgot to enable the adjustments. And well, let's pay attention to it as we change it. So that's how it looks. Yeah. I mean, that is a very subtle change. I don't know if you could even notice it. I did see it, but it was pretty subtle.
At that moment, I wasn't watching the screen.
I'm thinking it's so low opacity. I might even, specular also is low. They might like adjust the specular with the same kind of method. Let's just see how it looks. So usually the specular is kind of flat and not interesting. But let's just see what happens if we put this AC texture on there. Yeah, and so for this one, I'll just max out the contrast like insane and then reduce the opacity. So I use the camera raw filter because it has this, 300, has this texture slider and clarity slider. Yeah, so you can really max out all this. So it looks ridiculous. Maybe I don't even want to max out the texture, but those two, yeah. Well, we can remove the saturation. Yeah, so this is like insane contrast. And I think I'll make it even more insane by applying an adjustment. Actually, let's use legacy. Let's make it really crazy. We'll see how this looks. Well, this will look worse after the actual import because it modifies the normal map as well. But it's low specular, so I'm not too worried about it. So I'm going to put it on overlay, I guess. And it looks... Is it an illusion? It looks blue to me. No, it's an illusion. Okay. And I'll reduce the opacity. Actually, the fill. Yeah, like what are the brightest values here right now? I know it looks really dark. So it's like 10-15%. Go a tiny bit higher. Let's see how this looks. So this will look better because there's no compression right now. But still, we can look at it. Did it break something? No, it didn't.
Well, also, those should be rounded. Would you leave them like this?
No, they shouldn't be rounded. That's how the vents are in real life.
Okay.
They're like harsh. So if I put the light lower, it might be more obvious what I just did. Yeah, this is super subtle. Yeah, I might make it more intense, like way harsher. Because when it's the specular highlight on a bright object, it's not that obvious. Okay, now this is too...
It's too much.
Yeah.
But I like it. It's not bad. It's looking like a roughness.
Yeah. It looks like stained and stuff. Wait, let's look on the side. Yeah, like on the side, you can also see this highlight. Yeah, it's just a tiny bit too much. I'll just reduce it slightly. Okay. That's fine. Okay, that's figured out. What's next? I guess we should check the illumination at night. I need to unpause the game so they get electricity. Okay. So this is how it looks when it's all lit up. And this one is like half lit up. So I think it's just too bright. Like these look like way too white to me. And this one, I guess, is like halfway. It's right now gradienting, you know, as it moves, as it changes during the night. Yeah, so let's go to the illumination. Let's remove those levels so it's not confusing. Yeah, I think it's these ones that have a lot of bright going on. So let's overlay something. I don't know, something that's not completely flat, but not too crazy either. Let's maybe grab this stuff, like something from here. Where is it? Okay, probably put it inside there. Desaturate, and I'll just scale it over the entire thing. This is not going to be too visible. It's just kind of an overlay. Yeah, like that. And can put it on the others as well, I guess. But not as harshly. And tone it down and make it darker. Probably increase the contrast, actually. Okay, let's try this. Yeah, this looks way better to me. Now it doesn't look like flat white. The only problem is, I guess, it's kind of repetitive. You can see how each window is the same as the other one. But I guess it's not too bad. Oh yeah, this one is also a bit lit up in a different way. So you can see, like, when it's not totally lit up, you can only see the brighter parts. And the top one is also illuminating like that.
That looks amazing.
Oh, and the color of this light is based on the map theme. So the map theme itself has the color set of what colors the windows can be. And if I fast forward it right now, we should be able to see how the colors slowly change. You can see these ones are getting darker right now.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, both of them are. Let's put some others into view. Yeah, these ones are also, I think, getting darker. Is there anything that's lighting up right now? Yeah, these ones are lighting up right now. Yeah, I prefer that this worked in a different way, where we could somehow mask each different window or each different floor or something, and then they would suddenly turn on and off. So that would actually simulate how lights work in real life, you know. You actually turn it on. You don't wait 2 hours for a light to fade on. These are coming on now. Yeah, it's fine. What about the lower ones? I didn't pay too much attention. Are these ones turning off or on? I guess they're going off. Where's the lit up bottom floor? Okay, this one has a... So here you can see the plant. It's not too bad. There's just two plants.
Yeah.
It's a bit weird how this is brighter than that, but I guess it's not a big issue. And here are the cakes. Doesn't look too bad, actually. I mean, obviously the perspective breaks immediately. When you look at it like this, like it looks like a lit-up storefront to me. So I think that's fine. Yeah, I think illumination is fine. So I'm not going to be checking it anymore. Let's just look at the model in general. So there you can see the shadows are going through. That's because of the shadow bias. But if you don't have any shadow bias, then the shadow acne is an issue. You can't see it much right now. And I can also reduce shadows to very short. We'll make them a bit sharper up close, I guess. And I can also adjust the cascades. And I think I have some AO enabled here. So yeah, you can see the AO I use is very subtle. I don't like it when it's too harsh. So I have it just a very subtle darkening. The reason I don't like it too harsh, because it's just in the sunlight, it's much more visible, which is kind of the opposite of what it should be. So it just looks super fake to me. Anyway, so if we disable the AO, you can still see that this has some depth to it because we added the fake AO on the diffuse. Otherwise, all this would look like super flat and you wouldn't be able to see where each individual column is and stuff like that. And with the AO, it adds quite a lot of depth to it, but it's a bit of a different look. It's like kind of big. And let's pay attention to the normal map. Like, what's a good thing to look at for the normal map? These windows, I guess.
Yeah.
I actually want to check the roof itself as well. Like, if I put the light at a very harsh angle, like, let's put it there. Let's make the sun really bright, like this. Well, here we should see the specular. Yeah. And on the roof itself has a normal map. It's not that strong, actually. I might even make it stronger. Let's see. Oh, but if I re-import the normal map, again, it's going to look better because it's going to have no specular. No compression, I mean. Let's increase the contrast of this. If I put this normal map, yeah, it's a bit stronger now. Oh, you can really see the normal map on the vents.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and I put it on the door textures as well for the ACs. Let's look at that. Yeah, you can really see it there. Oh, I think I forgot something on the normal map. These columns were supposed to... This was supposed to have a normal map as well. So let's add that. So I need to actually see where to add it. Do I still have the diffuse here? No. I'll just duplicate this document, flatten it, and bring it over there so I can see what I'm working on. So I want I want these columns to have some normal map as well. Let's see if we can add it only on the inside here or on the edges as well, maybe. So I want this, and it's going to be 1 pixel in there, like that. Yeah. Save this and test it in game. Yeah, I wanted that.
Mm. Nice.
I'm thinking if I could actually make rounded edges for these columns. It depends how they're UV mapped. Let's quickly check. Let's select all of them. See, are they all UV mapped? Yeah, they're kind of UV mapped on the same spot. So it could work. But what is that? Oh, that's used for the top. So that might screw up the top. It might look weird on the top. Anyway, let's try it. So this will be 1 pixel out. And it should be somewhere there, I guess. And this should be like 50% opacity. So this should be on the edges of these columns. Okay, it did add it a bit on one side. I'm not sure if it's that visible on the other side. I might need to change the UV mapping. Oh, it is kind of visible on the other side as well. So what this means... Yeah, it's not actually visible. So from the other side, let's see. Yeah, if we're looking like this, yeah, each thing is UV mapped differently. So, but on these, you can see the edge is rounded, so now it gets a bit of sunlight from the other side. But does it screw with the top here? Not too much, actually. So I still might... I might still do it. I think I did it on this edge. Yeah, this edge is like rounded. I think both of these are slightly rounded.
Yeah.
Yeah, I might need to adjust the UV mapping, but it's doable. Also, the same goes for this thing as well. If I do that, this doesn't look right at all. How is this UV mapped? Oh, this has quite a gap on the left side and not that much on that side, so... Something like this, I guess. Let's try it. Well, this doesn't look symmetric, so... Because I think this should be symmetric. So it's 16 here, 17. Yeah, it should be like this. Yeah, so this will... The UV mapping will need to be adjusted because it's not UV mapped properly. Just a tiny bit off. That's easy to fix. I should fix it now, otherwise I'm going to forget. So I'm going to... The texture that I'm actually using in Maya is this one. So I need to... Okay. And normal map. So I have selected both of these. And I should move them slightly. No, actually, you should scale them down. Kind of difficult to see here. Yeah, it should be something like that. And the other ones also need to be adjusted. Yeah, this should be something like this. That's fine. Now, even in Maya, I have the normal map set up, right? So I should be able to see those. Yeah. You can see how this edge is rounded to that side. This one is rounded.
Oh, that's so nice.
And this one should align properly as well. Yeah, it looks like it. Yeah, that will be fine. Yeah, I like the normal map. These vents have a lot of depth. Let's put it more of a daytime. On these circles as well, you should be able to see. Yeah. Actually, how you can see the normal map more is by opening some kind of info view, like transport. You can see only the normal map now, like without the texture.
It wasn't hitting the bulldozer or something, I think.
Yeah, I guess. Well, anyone that brings up that stuff. Yeah, you can see the normal map.
Very, very nice.
Yeah, the environment reflection is not very strong in city skylines. Like, you can barely see it here. I guess even in the shadow, yeah, there's something weird about it. How, like, it makes sense that in the sunlight, the environment is not that noticeable because everything is lit up so much by the sun. But in the shadow, I mean, why does it look so dark? Sky reflection should be much brighter. Like, you can barely see the sky in the reflections.
Mm-hmm.
But in real life, where's the shadowy side? I mean, look how bright the reflections are. Because the sunlight is not here, all you see a lot of the sky reflection. Unfortunately, in games, not like that. Okay, so anything else do you need to test or adjust?
Don't think so. Looks pretty fine.
Yeah.
Except the color, but that's for later.
Oh yeah, the color map. We can do it right now, actually. In game, we can test it in game because we can replace textures, and that's all we need actually. So
yeah,
here I'm gonna do a bit of an interesting trick that I don't think I ever did this trick, but well, let me close all the unnecessary stuff, and collapse everything. Save. Yeah, save this as well, I guess. Okay. So I'm going to duplicate this document. Wait. Let me think about this a bit. So this is the final texture, how it looks in game. And I want to remove the brown, basically, and I replace it by a color variation. And the way I'm going to do that... So first, I'm going to... This is a new document, so I can flatten everything into a flat... Well, you can just right-click on anything and... Oh, actually, you need to right-click on a raster layer to do flatten. Yeah, flatten image. Okay, that's how it works. I just have it on a hotkey. So I need to select all the brown that I want the color from. So that will be the tiles and the brown panels. So the way I'm going to do that is I'm just going to put black over the windows first. And then just select everything that is not this. That I think will be easier. Okay. And I only need to cover the brown part because that's what I'm coloring. Like this. And I guess the door will also be included because it's also the same brown. Otherwise, it'll look out of place. And, well, I guess I'll cover the sides. So black is everything that I don't want to select right now. Like that. And this goes all the way to the door. This. Okay. So now let's merge these new things, select it, and invert. Okay. So now this thing is all the brown stuff. And I'll duplicate it again. I'll select all of that. Just control clicking the thumbnail selects the visible stuff. And do a blur average. This is the average color of all the brown stuff. So I'll put this over the diffuse above the adjustments, like this. And, you know, I'm going to use this color to multiply in game, right? Uh-huh. So, but yeah. I want to remove this color from this. And what's the opposite of multiply? Uh-huh. It's divide. So we'll divide. And it makes it white. But the problem is that it's going to be so white that it's actually too bright. So I'll need to darken this a tiny bit or brighten it. Well, wait, let me see. Okay, yeah, I need to lift the black slightly. Actually, what happens if I do reduce the fill? No, that actually doesn't bring back the detail. Because right now stuff here is so white that it destroyed the details. So I need to bring up this black point. Well, it's not too bad. Yeah, like this. And I'll also do another adjustment where I reduce the saturation because I had this random color here, I want to remove some of that. Not completely, but a bit. Yeah, I think that's okay. Yeah, so this will be my diffuse texture. And I'm going to multiply that by this color. But we'll adjust the color a bit and we'll pick four different colors. But for now, I'll literally just pick this color, see what the values are, and that's the values we're going to do. So let's put the diffuse. So obviously it looks ridiculous, but what I'm going to do is, buildings you can select and do show in Scene Explorer. But if you have a prop, then you'll need to do it differently. So I'll just show it for example. So I have the office selected for plopping as a building, I'm plopping it. So in mod tools, you can do show current tool, and that will show the current tool, which is the building tool, which I'm plopping the building with. So, and there's m_prefab. That's the asset itself. And here, I don't remember which ones we need to change, these colors or the ones in material. I guess we'll need to experiment. Where's the material itself? here's material, and here's some colors here. So I'll just change all the colors here to something random, just so I can see what's happening. And buildings don't change immediately. You actually need to like move them or something. But I think I have a script to update color variations for buildings. If it's a prop, it's easier. Then you don't need to do this. Yeah, so there's this script called buildingManager.instance update building colors. So that's what I'm going to use to update the colors of the already placed buildings.
I never did any of this.
Yeah, well, I like to adjust the color.
It's fast. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so that's... now this is here, and every time I press the up, it's going to bring it up, so I can do it all the time. Anyway, so what I need to put in there... Actually, I need to find the building again because I closed the current tool. That's what I don't like about this method. So the way I'm going to do it here, I'm going to actually close the current tool, and instead of doing show current tool here, I'm going to just find the building tool. Yeah, it's in tool controller, building tool. Or if you had a prop, you would just find the prop tool. It's a very similar idea. So in prefab, so there's the colors. And let's put in this color. So 77, 68, 62. And I'm just going to copy the same one to all of them for now. And I'm going to run the script. Okay, so now we need to make the color map. Otherwise, it's multiplying the entire building and it's super dark. So the color map will be just this same mask, you know? So let's just take this and drag this into this one. Because here I want... Wait, I did something wrong. Let's create a new group and call it C. And where was this? Yeah, let's just drag this thing in here. And the background is going to be black, so no color variation. And this thing is going to be white, which means full color variation. So it will fully multiply by that color. Yeah, so this is the color map itself. So let's just save this as underscore C. And replace color. Okay, now it did it. But we made it a bit darker before because it was too white on the diffuse. So this is a bit too dark compared to what I actually wanted it to be. So let's just let's apply the same levels adjustment to the color. Yeah. So let's now sample this color. 88, 79, 73.
This is the best color map I ever seen, honestly.
What do you mean?
I know, not necessarily the color map, but the way to do this with the mod tools. I have to try this thing.
Something didn't paste. Okay. And wait. Oh, I needed to run the script for the colors. Right. This is why I sometimes import stuff as a prop, because I don't need to run that script. But I kind of forgot about it. Oh, but we wanted to test the building illumination anyway. So anyway, so this now looks, I think it looks about the same color that it was before. It looks right to me.
Yeah.
So let's decide the other colors. Let's just put a random color in each one for now. So it's easy to identify which one is which. Like this. Yeah. Let's do that and copy this building a bunch of times. Let's put it like here. Okay. And put all of them, ignore the broken LOD, we'll work on the LOD later. Put all of the colors here. Okay. So what colors should we pick? Like one definitely could go like in between the brown and the beige, like a middle color between those two. So let's just, let's merge this. Let's just crop it here. And let's select this. And this is going to be your color. So it's just going to be a brighter, maybe introduce a bit of yellow there as well. I should have made a group actually for this. Yeah. So maybe make it slightly yellow. Yeah, like that. Let's try this color. So 111, 101, 88. I'm going to do the red one replace 111, 101, 88. Okay, so it's just a brighter brown, basically. That's fine. Another one we could go for is like a gray, a more desaturated one, I guess. maybe the same kind of brightness, but just desaturated. Just saturation 0. Let's do 110. So 110 for all of them, but maybe not completely desaturated. So do like 5%. And like something like that, 112, 110, and 107. Oh, it was that one I changed. Yeah, this one looks okay as well. It looks very weird to me now that I looked at the reference for so long, but I think, like in general, it doesn't look bad.
Mm-hmm.
And what could be the fourth one we go for? Something like more intense, maybe like an actual red or orange. It's a bit more saturated. Let's try it. I'll just place a rectangle here.
I would have tried something more neutral.
Like yeah, I just wanted
closer to gray.
Let's try this. Yeah, like red, like that. Let's try that. Well, the point of the color map is people can use the mod. Which one was the new one? Which was the old one? I think there's a mod called Painter and then a mod called Paint It. Or something.
Yeah, I have no idea.
I don't remember which one is newer, but basically people can just pick any color they want using it. So that's the good thing. These preset colors are just like, they don't matter that much, I guess. 71, 68. Whoops. Yeah, that one looks a bit too dark, I think. But it doesn't look bad as a building color, I think. It's just a bit too dark, I would say. Slightly desaturate, slightly towards yellow, and slightly brighter. Oh, whoops, I wasn't actually changing the color. So, slightly towards yellow, desaturate, a bit brighter. Let's try that one. So, 107, 79, 75. And do the script. Yeah, that looks fine to me. So, these four colors. Yeah, I think it's fine.
Your choice. I like anyway.
Now let's actually check the other side. Yeah, I think all of those look like plausible. I don't know, is the roof a bit too bright maybe? I know the reference is quite bright. It's not like one of those dark gray roofs. Still, it looks a bit weird.
Yeah, it is a bit.
I'll darken it a tiny bit.
Hmm.
Or I'll do like both darkening and contrast increase at the same time, like that. And I'll reduce the opacity because I did it like way intense. So something like this. Yeah, I think that's fine. Okay, so I have the color map. I should write down these values.
Yeah, take a screenshot. Yeah.
I sometimes close the game and I don't even look at those. Yeah. And can you even put in values manually in the asset editor, like without mod tools?
I don't remember.
Well, anyway, I use this color variation script. So this is for props, mm-hmm. This is for buildings. Yeah, yeah. And I took a screenshot and I'll put those same values in here and then I can run it. So I don't need to like mess with mod tools again. So I'll do that later.
That's pretty cool.
Let's make sure that I have the... Yeah, yeah, I did take a screenshot of the values. Okay, so that's enough of testing in game. Do we need anything else?
Don't think so.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't think so.
So next
is LOD.
LOD, but I want to do the submesh for the stains on the roof.
Oh, right. The rotor shade, the rod, that's going to be interesting, yeah.
And also for the glass that will be in front of those things.
Mm-hmm. All right, so this is the next thing.
Yeah. I just noticed an issue. I didn't cap the top here. There's literally no cap. Let's fix that. And I can cap this top. Is there any texture that's like useful for the top? I don't think so. I guess I'll just use a random part of the AC stuff. Wait, what is even the thing using? Oh, it is using the AC texture. Okay, so same for the top, I guess. I guess I could put it so that there's a dark spot near the edge. Like that. Yeah. Okay. I hope there weren't any other issues that we missed.
All right.